الحمد لله حمدا طاهرا طيبا مباركا فيه. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا ومن سيئات اعمالنا. من يهدي الله فهو المهتد، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له، واشهد ان سيدنا وحبيبنا ومولانا وقائدنا ومعلمنا وعظيمنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم أرسله الله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا بين يدي الساعة. من يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز ورشد، ومن يعص الله ورسوله فلا يضر إلا نفسه ولا يضر الله شيئا. Praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him who seek His help, and in Him subhanahu wa ta'ala we seek refuge from every evil in ourselves. I give witness that Allah is the one, the only one, the eternal, the absolute. And I give witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his servant and a prophet, whom he sent to the truth as a giver of good tidings and a warner before the coming of the hour. Whosoever obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will be rightly guided. And whosoever disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will bring harm to himself and no harm to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون، دعونا نسترجع الأحداث وما مر ويمر على أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، ففيها الدروس والعبر. Let us recall the events as they happened before and what is happening today. For in it, we'll see lessons and wisdoms. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون، لقد شكل الغرب بالأمس كتيبة الإعدام، وشاركت معه في الجريمة ثمة منظومة عربية نتهمها اليوم بقتل فلسطين والعراق وأفغانستان، جريمة مع سبق الإصرار والترصد. Not that long ago, when the Western governments have composed a brigade for the execution of Palestine, the execution of Iraq, the execution of our Ummah, and the execution of Afghanistan. With them cooperated some assembly of Arabs and the Islamists. Today we accuse them for the killing of Palestine, Iraq, and Afghanistan. A premeditated crime, well planned, well executed. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون، كانت المنظومة العربية الإسلامية على موعد مع العار لتمرير إعدام العراق. كانت منها حفنة من الحكام المتصهينين ليحملوا أوزارهم وأوزار من يضلونهم، وكان منها حفنة من علماء السوء ليضفوا الشرعية على الجريمة، وكان منها الكتاب والصحفيين كانت مهمتهم تزوير المجد والتاريخ لصالح تل أبيب وواشنطن. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون، The Assembly of the Arab and the Islamist organizations, they were at a date with shame in order to pass the execution of Iraq. Amongst them were a squad of rulers, dealers rather. They were more Zionists than the Zionists themselves. in order to carry their sins and the sins of those whom they misguide. And amongst them were a group of corrupted scholars in order to add legitimacy to the crime. And amongst them were a squad of writers and the journalists. Their role was to falsify the glory and the history of our Ummah for the benefit of Tel Aviv and Washington. ولا يغيب عنا ذاك الكم الهائل من الفضائيات التي لا نعرف ما هي مهمتهم في الحياة وكانوا وما زالوا يتراقصون على جراح الأمة واشتغلوا بأمور تجعل الحليم حيران وتجعل المؤمن يندى جبيله من العار. And we cannot forget that great number of satellite channels that we do not know what their function in life. They wear and they still dance on the wounds of the Ummah. And they occupy themselves with issues that make you perspire of shame. وكنا نتساءل and we were questioning ourselves ما هذا الذي يحدث؟ What is going on؟ ماذا يعني تغييب الأمة في قنوات فضائية تحمل للعالم المسلم عهره اليود؟ Questioning ourselves what is going on؟ What does it mean that these satellite channels bring to the Muslim world the vulgarity and the indecency of Hollywood. إنه لا يندى جبين المؤمن عندما يرى الواقع العربي من المحيط إلى الخارج. Indeed, the free, the believer, perspire of shame when he look at the status of the Arab nations from the ocean to the Gulf. وإذا نظرت إلى السجون والمعتقلات شرقا وغربا تجدها مملوءة بأبناء الإسلام. ولنا أن نحدد على من تقع اللائمة في الانتقال من سياق المجد والتاريخ والعظمة لأمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم إلى ما نحن فيه من العار من سياق العار في تلك الأيام. Indeed, the believer perspires of shame when you look at the status of the Arab nations from the ocean to the Gulf. And if you look at the jails, the prisons, and the dungeons, left and right, east and west, you find it is full of Muslim people. And we have to define exactly to whom we should put the blame for transferring the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam from the status of dignity and the greatness to what we have today of shame, status of shame and the surrender. And what a shame on the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam to be led by people so-called leaders, dealers like Bin Ali or Mubarak, or هذا المعتوه, the Pharaoh of Libya, who is killing his own people in order to remain in charge after 42 years. Killing his own people, that his own principal job is to protect the people, not to terrorize the people, to terrorizing his own brothers and the sisters. What shame on the Muslim Ummah that the Western world, the Kafir world, ask a Muslim not to kill his brothers and his sisters and terrorize his own people. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون, الكفر اليوم شاهر سيفه. Today atheism and the kufr is raising their sword and they welcome to the age of Obamism and Clintonism, after the age of Bushism and Condillacism. Welcome to the new age. لقد كفر العرب بإرث المجد. Arabs rejected to inherit the greatness and the dignity and the honor of the Ummah of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. كفروا بمجد بني تغلب وخيلاء قريش وشموخ بني عبد المطلب وبني هاشم. وها هو الإسلام يهان على يد حكامه. خانوا الله ورخانوا الرسول، خانوا الأرض والعرض وباعوا الأرض والعرض. اللهم إنا نسألك أن تكون في نحورهم يا رب العالمين. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون، indeed we are, it's in a very difficult time. It's a very shameful time that we are in, that we're killing ourselves. We wanted to suffocate the voice of our own people, asking for freedom and human rights, dignity. But these people who betrayed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, betrayed their deen, betrayed their faith, betrayed their land, betrayed the honor of the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون، أولم يهدي، الله سبحانه وتعالى said، أولم يهدي للذين يرثون الأرض من بعد أهلها. ألا أصبناهم، ألا لو يشاء الله أصبناهم بذنوبهم ونطبع على قلوبهم فهم لا يسمعون. الله سبحانه وتعالى said to those who are inheriting the earth in succession from the people who have it before them. Wouldn't that make sense to them? Can't they understand that if we willed, we would punish them with their sins and seal up their hearts so they do not hear anything? Hearing the wisdom, that is, you contemplate on what is going on around you. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون، لقد اقترفت الجرائم في بلاد المسلمين على المسلمين، وكانت البشرية جميعا لها شهود. Indeed the crimes were committed against the Muslim Ummah, the Muslim people, and the whole wide world were witnessing to it. Under all the massacres that happened in Bosnia Herzegovina and the massacres of Kosovo, massacres in Iraq and the massacres on Palestine for the last 60 years. وليس ببعيد عندما نشاهد، is not far when we witness the crimes and the massacres against the Palestine, against the Gazan people, with the cooperation of Egypt and the Bani Ya'rub and the rest of the Arabs. وكم شاهدت قناة السويس وأرض الكويت ذبح العراق. And how often that the Suez Canal and the land of Kuwait witnesses or participated to slaughter the Iraq. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون، لقد مررت الأنظمة العربية العار على أرضها ودينها ومجدها وتاريخها. وها نحن نلجأ إلى العدو الأول للإسلام والمسلمين لينقذ المسلمين بعضهم من بعض وينقذ المسلمين من حكامهم. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون، indeed this Arab regime they have passed the shame on their own land, on their own faith, on their own glory, and in own history. And here today we are asking the first of our enemies to help us against our own rulers who are killing us, threatening us, terrorizing us. We are going to kill you, going after you from door to door, from an apartment to apartment. No mercy. انظر إلى هذا المعتوه. Look at that lunatic when he is threatening his own people and saying no mercy. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful. How often we commit crimes in offense to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. But that infinitism being said no mercy. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون، this is the shame that the Muslim Ummah are living in. ثم كانت ثورة الشباب في تونس ومصر، وها هي في ليبيا وفي اليمن وفي البحرين وفي الجزائر وفي العراق وفي سوريا. And here comes after day late, after a long sleep, the awakening of the youth of the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And here we hear the cries that filled the Arab world asking for freedom and human rights and the dignity. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون، إن فرعون وهامان وجنودهما، إن فرعون علا في الأرض وجعل أهلها شيعا يستضعف طائفة منهم يذبح أبناءهم ويستحيي نساءهم إنه كان من المفسدين. ونريد أن نمن على الذين استضعفوا منهم ونجعلهم أئمة ونجعلهم الوارثين. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the glorious Quran. And if these people read the Quran, you would have never done what they are doing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the parable of Pharaoh. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, indeed, Pharaoh has elated himself in the land and subdivided, broke up his people into sects and sections. Some he terrorized, killing their own, the males, and keeping the females. That is for the enjoyments of the Egyptians, of the Pharaoh. And we want to be gracious to these people who were depressed. That is by Pharaoh. And we give them leadership and to inherit. That's the faith. And our rulers of the Muslim world today, they did what Pharaoh never thought, never dared, never came to his mind to do. Our rulers of today, for what? To stay more years in as a chief, to loot more money that you will never finish it until you and your whole descendants and your family die until the end of time. Why? Dunya, you sell your akhirah for few pennies of this dunya. Indeed, the revolt of the youth in the Muslim Ummah, in the Arab world today, nadiru khayrin wa baraka. Indeed, is an indicative of good. And inshallah, it will be a baraka on the Ummah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yu'ti al-mulk man yasha' wa yanzi'u al-mulk mimman yasha' yu'izzu man yasha' wa yudhillu man yasha' biyadihi al-khayr wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, when the time has come, he said, be, and it was. He gives the power to whom subhanahu wa ta'ala he pleases. And strip off the power from those whom he loves as he pleases subhanahu wa ta'ala. He gives the honor as he pleases subhanahu wa ta'ala. And take the honor, humiliate those as he pleases subhanahu wa ta'ala. All the good in his hand, he is the most powerful subhanahu wa ta'ala. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون إذا نظرنا إلى الواقع الجغرافي في العالم حاليا نجد أنه يستلزم جديدا من الفتوحات الإسلامية. If we look at the geographical status of the world today, we immediately see the necessity for Islam to propagate, to spread rights, dignity, humanity, spread the civilization of Islam once again. كم تحدثنا عن عظمة القرآن في سرد حلولا مستفيضة من تجارب ومعالجة أنبياء الله تبارك وتعالى للواقع الكوني، وكم أشرنا إلى الآصرة القوية بين الإسلام والثورة، لأن أنبياء الله تبارك وتعالى كانوا ثوار الله تبارك وتعالى على الأرض، علموا الإنسانية كيف يقفوا حماية للحق وكيف يقفوا أمام الباطل، يدافعون عن الحق. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون، how many times we talked about the greatness of the Quran when he gave us the detailed solutions that came out of the experience of the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when they dealt with the situations at their time. And how much we talked about the tie between the revolution and the Islam. Because in fact, the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messengers, they were the revolutionaries of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on earth. They taught mankind how to stand in front of evil, how to stand in front of injustice. They taught mankind how to stand for the haqq, for the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the truth. They were the true revolutionaries of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on earth. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون، وكم قلنا أن الله تبارك وتعالى لا يطلب ولا يستجدي من عباده نصرة دينه، ولا أن يأمرهم أن يكونوا رجالا، ولكن عندما يرى الله تبارك وتعالى أنهم لا يستحقون شرف التضحية ينزل بهم من صفحة التاريخ ويحل محلهم قوم يحبهم ويحبونه. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون، how often we talked about that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not beg from his servant to support his cause or to demand on the people to be true men. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he sees that this man do not deserve the honor of sacrifice, he dropped them off the pages of history and replace them with others who love him and he loves him subhanahu wa ta'ala. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون، ثورات الشباب، the revolutions of the youth of today and everybody in Muslim societies against the tyranny, against الظلم والطغي والاستبداد. Indeed, this revolution revolves of the youth against the tyranny and the corruption and the killing of innocent people. Indeed, it is the call against every system, every rulings that away from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Indeed, it is against every government that withholds the power
He held the people's political life. They looted their country. They were withhold their wealth. And they terrorized their own people. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون, they said that the Arab world, by and large, is absolutely nothing but a something that the West can move left or right as they wish. And they said, when the Arabs are going to own their own destiny. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون, كانت الشعوب وما زالت تنظر إلى حكامها نظرة احتقار, نظرة حزينة تخرج من عمق الألم على ما يرونه من مجازر لإخوانهم من المسلمين والمسلمات. And how was the, how was the where did the Muslim world look and still look at the rulers with all a look of despise, a look, a sad, very sad look that is coming from the depth of the pain that they have inside them when they see the crimes committed against innocent people, whether at the hands of the Western governments or their own people, their own rulers, that the very principal job of theirs is to protect their own people, to defend their own people, to honor their own people, not to despise their own people, kill their own people, threatening their own people, looting their own people. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون, I call on the long-awaited caliph of the Muslim Ummah and you tell him, هنيئاً لك يا خليفة المسلمين فتيانك الصغار الذين أتوا من رحم الزمان بعد طول انتظار ليعودوا بنا إلى زمن الثورات, زمن العظماء الذين غيروا وجه التاريخ إلى الأبد. Indeed, the long-awaited caliph of the Muslim Ummah, we congratulate you in a way for your young man, this generation of young men that who came out from the womb of time, the womb of history, to take us back to the age of revolutions, the age of greatness, that they changed the face of history forever. You take us back to the days of the glory, the days of revolution against all tyrannies, dictators, the corrupt people. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون, we call on the Muslim caliphs, how much we are longing to see you, to change and to lead us in prayers and to take your hands over the heads of the orphans and how many of them now at the hands of the Pharaoh of Libya and was at the Pharaoh of Egypt and the Pharaoh of Tunisia. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون, how much we long to see our caliph as prophesied by Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. Lead us in prayers. How often we beg Allah سبحانه وتعالى and we hope inshallah that all these revolts of the youth in the Arab world that Allah سبحانه وتعالى bring them all home to safety and to all the goodness and to live in harmony and the true brotherhood. How often we beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make Egypt a true Muslim land, to make Tunisia a true Muslim land, to make Yemen a true Muslim land, to make Libya a Muslim, true Muslim land, to make Algeria and the Iraq and all the Muslim world Muslim countries. Rather, we beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to unite all this ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam into one ummah, because as such Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala defined the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. إن هذه أمتكم أمة واحدة وأنا ربكم فاعبدون. This ummah of yours is one single brotherhood and I am your Lord, so worship me. So we beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring all these small little countries, cantons, bring them all together into one ummah as defined by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that this ummah is one single ummah. وتكون إن شاء الله بلا حدود ولا قيود. No borders, no limitations, but it's an open Muslim world propagating the word of the truth, the world of dignity, the world of humanity. والله غالب على أمره ولكن أكثر الناس لا يعلمون. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. أستغفر. الحمد لله الواحد الأحد الفرد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. الحمد لله الخالق البارئ المصور له الأسماء الحسنى. يسبح له ما في السماوات والأرض وهو العزيز الحكيم. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات. اللهم انصر إخواننا المجاهدين في الحق في كل مكان يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصرهم على أرض ليبيا يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصرهم على أرض ليبيا يا رب العالمين. وطهر هذا البلد الأمين يا رب العالمين من الزنادقة يا رب العالمين ومن أعداء الله يا رب العالمين وأعداء الإنسانية يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر إخواننا في مصر وانصر إخواننا في تونس وانصر إخواننا المجاهدين في الحق في اليمن يا رب العالمين وفي العراق والجزائر وسوريا يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارزقنا نصرا مبينا يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر إخواننا المجاهدين في الحق في فلسطين يا رب العالمين. وطهر مسجدك الأقصى يا رب العالمين من إنجاس اليهود يا رب العالمين. اللهم طهرهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم اكتب لهم نصرا مبينا يا رب العالمين. اللهم حرر مسجدنا الأقصى يا رب العالمين وحرر أرض فلسطين يا رب العالمين. اللهم أكرمنا ولا تهنا وأعطنا ولا تحرمنا وارض عنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم أهلك الظالمين بالظالمين. اللهم أهلك الظالمين بالظالمين. اللهم أهلك الخونة والعلمانيين. اللهم أهلك من خانونا وباعونا وباع الأرض والعرض يا رب العالمين. اللهم تقبل منا يا رب العالمين وانصرنا يا رب العالمين النصر المبين يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا. ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. صلى الله عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله. صلى الله عليك وعلى آلك وصحبك أجمعين. وأقم الصلاة.